Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Hebrews 3:12-17. See to it, brothers and sisters, that none of you has a sinful, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God. But encourage one another daily, as long as it is called today, so that none of you may be hardened by sin's deceitfulness. We have come to share in Christ, if indeed we hold our original conviction firmly to the very end. As has just been said. Today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts, as you did in the rebellion. Who were they who heard and rebelled? Were they not all those Moses led out of Egypt? And with whom was he angry for 40 years? Was it not with those who sinned, whose bodies perished in the wilderness? Today's title is Today If You Hear His Voice. Our life on earth is a pilgrimage to heaven. The Bible says it clearly. Dear friends, I urge you, as foreigners and exiles, to abstain from sinful desires, which wage war against your soul. 1 Peter 2:11. What characterizes the life of foreigners and exiles? They do not want to stay on earth for good. They eagerly and anxiously wait for the time to return to home. They go through a lot of accusations and persecutions on earth, for they do not conform to the worldly ways of life but strive to follow the word of God. At the same time, they should not antagonize the people they encounter on their pilgrimage but to bring them to the Lord. How can they do that? The Bible clearly shows how. Live such good lives among the pagans that, though they accuse you of doing wrong, they may see your good deeds and glorify God on the day he visits us. 1 Peter 2:11-12. We Christians do not intend or indulge in worldly affairs. We have the eternal home in heaven. But that doesn't mean we are disinterested in earthly affairs and earthly people. As much as we long for the heavenly home, we do our best to live as good and faithful servants of the Lord on earth. We do not take our responsibility as good citizens and as good neighbors lightly. So how do we keep the yearning for the eternal home and fulfill faithfully all the earthly responsibilities in balance? In other words, how do we live good lives among the pagans at the same time we keep pressing on the heavenly home as a pilgrim? Today's passage gives a good answer to the question that we all have. First, do not harden your hearts if you hear his voice today. The Lord is watching over us as we walk toward the heavenly home. He directs and guides us with his own words as needed. That was exactly what he did for the Israelites in the wilderness. Secondly, we should guard our hearts against a sinful, unbelieving heart that turns away from the living God by the words. Thirdly, encourage one another daily so that none of us may be hardened by sin's deceitfulness. No one is strong enough to finish a pilgrimage by his or her strength alone. We need each other. That's why we need a church. So how is your pilgrim's progress going? Are you walking steadfastly to the heavenly home? It all depends on if you hear his voice today.